Hello, welcome. In this Excel tip, we're going to talk about the very powerful program Dview. Now, let's say we have a data set like this that we've been looking at. And again, we just have our month, the hour of the day, and solar power, the dry bulb temperature and relative humidity, wind speed and temperature. And we want to be able to view these visually very nicely. Now, I've gone over some ways we can do this in Excel, but there's also a really nice program called Dview. What Dview does is it takes data that's very similar to this, that has 8,760 data points, which are hourly data points, and plots them nicely for you. So the nice thing about Dview is it plots them nicely. The downfall is it's got to be 8,760 data points, which is sort of a downfall. But a lot of data sets are like this, and you'll see that in this in the energy program. Okay, so let's go ahead. The first thing is that Dview does not like working with Excel 2013 files. So what we're going to do is the first thing we're going to do is we're going to go to File, Save As, and we'll just save it in my Videos folder. And we're going to save this as a, instead of as a type Excel workbook, we're going to save it as a comma delimited, a CSV. I already have one that's saved like that, so we'll just rewrite over it. And we're going to go ahead and hit Save. And you can't see the save, but let me show you. So now you can see it's comma delimited, and now we're going to hit Save. We're going to replace it. We're going to keep using this format. And then we don't want this to be open in Excel when Dview is open, so let's go ahead and shut that. Okay, so now this is Dview, and this can be downloaded by the link at the beginning of the video, but also the link in the description below. So go ahead and go to File, Open, and then we're going to find that sheet that we just saved, that CSV sheet, and hit Open. Okay, so there's a couple different things that we can see here. First off, this is a graph. This is an hourly graph. Now this one, if we hit this little plus minus thing up here, it shows us all the data that we can plot. This one, we're plotting the month. So it makes sense. January is the first month, February is the second, March is the third, and so on. Makes sense, but it's not particularly interesting. So let's look at a more interesting one. Let's look at dry bulb temperature. So this is the temperature trend throughout the whole year. And I sort of like it because you can see there was sort of a cold spell in the beginning of April and the beginning of March. And there was a warm spell in January and the end of February. And, so you can see a lot of stuff from this data. So the real power of Dview is that you could actually make this graph in Excel by just selecting all of the temperature values and plotting a line chart. But what's nice about Dview is right away, if we go to daily, what this does is it does a little data manipulation for us. So this is the daily averages of all the temperatures. So that's, so in this case, instead of there being 8,760 points, there are 365 data points, and it's just the average. Now Excel can do this with a pivot table, so, but Dview does it much quicker and makes the graph look pretty nice too. So the other thing we can always do is if we right click, we can copy the data, we can save the data, we can send the data to Excel, we can copy as an image, which are these, we can export, or we can export as a PDF or these things. So there's lots and lots of different options that we can do, which is really nice. The other thing we can go to, if we go to settings, we can do some other things like set the Y min and Y max, and do some different things. So now if we go to monthly and we go to temperature, now there's only 12 data points, 12 temperature data points, and that's the average monthly temperature. So again, it's pretty nice. Again, Excel can do this with pivot tables, but Dview does it very quickly. One thing that Excel doesn't do very nicely is this, or very easily at least, is this heat map. So again, we want to change from month to dry bulb temperature. So I love this heat map, one of my favorite data displays. What this is showing us is it's the month of the year on the bottom, the hour of the day on the left, and the color is the temperature. So you can see 46 degrees, this is Celsius, so it's a little bit weird to think about, and 1 degree here. So the red is the hottest times of the day, or hottest times of the year, and the black is the coldest. And you can see the black appears early in the morning hours and during the winter, and the red appears in the afternoon in, you know, June, July, and August. So that makes sense. So now one more thing to show you is the profile. So let's look at the profile again for the temperature. Let's get rid of the month. So this shows you all of the profiles, the daily profiles for every single month. So what this is doing in the month of January, it's taking the first hour and averaging all of those temperatures every day. It's taking the second hour and averaging all of those temperatures and doing that for every single hour of the day for just the month of January. If you want to do the whole year for just the hour of the day, that's the annual profile. So again, this gives you sort of a nice little view of what's going on. What's nice, what I like is temperature sort of obvious with this, but what I like is when we start putting things like wind speed in, where wind speed, there definitely are some weird profiles here. So it's sort of nice. The last thing I want to show you is this scatter. So this is actually new to this to Dview this year. And what we're going to do is, what scatter does is it plots in like, just like XY scatter in Excel, it plots two data points together. So for example, if we wanted to see what the relationship between temperature and wind speed is, we would type temperature here and wind speed here. And this is the relationship between temperature and wind speed. So sometimes scatter plots can really give you a good idea about what's going on. We could use temperature and relative humidity here. And you can sort of see that as temperature goes up, relative humidity goes down. Okay, so that's another sort of tool in your toolbox with Dview. Thanks for watching.